Hey everyone, Clark here from Clark Tech, and today meron tayong special guest. Yes, a very familiar guest from Shopee. That's right, this is the iPhone 4S. Right, so let's see kung worth it pa ba siyang gamitin this 2020. Let's go! This is the iPhone 4S, and I bought this on Shopee for 1,194 pesos only. With no accessories on board. Pero if you want na meron siyang kasamang accessories, then you have an option for that. So you can add at least 100 peso for that. Okay, and this is the black version. And I bought this with the front and back covering, as you have noticed. Yon. So at first glance, there are some scratches because it's a second-hand phone only. Yes, this is legit, pero yun nga, second-hand siya. But it can be hide naman or it can be hidden through this front and back covering. And also, meron din siyang other color options like the white version. So, hindi lang black version yung option mo, but you can also have the white version as well. And at the front, meron tayong 3.5-inch IPS LCD display. And this is the first iPhone with a retina display. Kaya the colors on this phone is much crisper than the previous generations, unlike the 4 and 3GS. And we also have this in front, the 0.3 megapixel camera, which is not quite good nga lang this 2020. And we also have here the iconic power button. And yes, wala tayong Touch ID dito kasi ang Touch ID is available on the 5S, on the iPhone 5S model, which is the later version of the iPhone. And at the back naman, so you can see meron tayo ditong 8 megapixel camera with 2.4 aperture, and this camera takes a decent job when it comes to the photos. So, but it cannot be compared nga lang to the latest phones that we are or that we have in the market right now. So, at the top, we also have the power button and also the 3.5mm headphone jack na hindi mo na rin makikita sa mga newest models ng iPhone right now. And also at the bottom, we have the 30-pin charger, and I believe this is also the last generation of iPhone that uses the 30-pin charger. After they upgraded it to the lightning charger, which you can see on the iPhone 5 na. Okay, on the left side naman, so we have here the silent button and also the volume buttons as well. And on the right side, we have the SIM card tray. This model is the 16GB model with 512MB of RAM. And as you can see, there is an available storage of 10.2GB. So this phone powers with the Apple A5 chip. And as you have noticed, I also installed some supporting apps from the apps that I installed from my iPhone 7 since I am using only one Apple ID for this device. So, this phone is currently on the most updated iOS na na-receive niya, which is the iOS 9.3.6. And surprisingly, Apple did this update just last year. And it is surprising also that they provide an update from a 9-year-old phone. For those who are asking if you can download apps on this phone, yes, you can download, but you can download the older supporting apps. So which means you cannot download the latest version of the apps from the App Store. Performance-wise, this phone will remind you that it is a very old phone. So most of the time when you are opening an app, medyo laggy siya and it will take time to open the app as well. But it is pretty usable pa naman considering this is an old phone. So battery-wise, it powers a 1432mAh battery, which is pretty small but decent comparing to its screen size. But it really drains so fast as of now. So if you are a light user, this phone can last up to 4 hours of usage. But if you are a heavy user, this phone can last you up until an hour or an hour and a half only. But due to its very small RAM, it is also impossible or almost impossible to open multiple apps at the same time. So should you buy this iPhone 4S this 2020? Well, it depends on how are you going to use this device. Kung ang purpose mo is to use this as your main device, I discourage you to buy this phone. First, due to its limited and laggy performance. Second, the battery life, which you will be needing to charge it multiple times a day. But if you are using this as a secondary phone, a phone for texting and calls, or a phone for music, so you can also consider buying this phone, because as of this year, I haven't encountered any problems with calls and texts on this phone. And you can also use, or you can also install the Spotify app on this phone, so you can also play music on this phone like an iPod. So that's it. Let me know in the comment section below if you have any device na gusto nyong i-review in the future. So thank you guys, and see you on the next review.